topic is about investigating the relationship between volume and pressure at constant temperature of a gas. First, let's discuss what gas is. Gas is one of the four main states of matter. It has no fixed shape, no fixed volume, and it expands to fill the space available. Intermolecular forces and gases are very small. There are gas laws which describe the properties and behavior of gases. Some of the variable of gas laws are pressure, volume, temperature, and moles. Let's discuss those variables. First is pressure. Pressure is the force that the gas exerts on a given area of the container. Next is volume. Volume is the three-dimensional space inside the container holding the gas. The third one is temperature. It is the measurement of how fast the particles are moving. The last one is mole. Mole is the unit of counting molecules, atoms, or any particle. Now, let's investigate the relationship between volume and pressure at constant temperature of a gas. It was developed by the scientist Robert Boyle at around 1660. It is known as Boyle's Law. Boyle's Law states that for a fixed mass of a gas, at a constant temperature, the product is a constant. Let's take a look at this illustration. Say we have a sealed cylinder which contains fixed mass, and kept at constant temperature. The gas pressure is created by the collision of gas molecules against the wall of the cylinder. The setup is used to investigate the relationship between pressure and volume at a constant temperature of a gas. To compress the gas, a force is exerted on the piston. As the piston compresses the gas, it gives higher and higher pressure on it. The pressure and volume are recorded as follows on the upper right side table. We can see that the values collected shows that the volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Therefore, initial pressure multiplied by the initial volume is equal to the final pressure multiplied by the final volume. Pressure times volume all throughout is constant. Also, we can conclude that a decrease in volume increases the number of gas particles per unit volume. This results in an increase in the number of gas particles close to the cylinder walls, and therefore an increase in the number of collisions with the wall. As the number of collisions per unit area increases, so does the force per unit area. Let's have this example. A container holds 500 milliliters of carbon dioxide at constant temperature of 20 degrees Celsius and a pressure of 742 torr. What will be the volume of the carbon dioxide if the pressure is increased to 795 torr? We are given with initial pressure, volume, and final pressure. Final volume is asked. In the solution, we used Boyle's law. Solving, our final volume is 462 milliliters carbon dioxide. Checking, our units are correct. We use Boyle's law and we conclude that as the pressure increases, the volume decreases. Here's the summary of our lesson about investigating the relationship between volume and pressure at constant temperature of a gas. This is the end of the presentation. Thank you.